Hello friends, change is perhaps the only constant, and funnily enough, one can never know when something creates a long-lasting impression in our life. Whether it's a virtue of kindness, whether it's a importance of smile, importance of forgiveness, these gifts of life comes in our life in the least expected ways, and when this incident or these stories or these things happens with us, we never remains the same what we are before that incident. Our point of view towards our life, our way of thinking, our way of looking towards the thing totally got changed. And in this video I am going to share a story from my life, and in this incident changed me a lot, and the way I work, it has changed me. So I believe that this incident will help you to learn something. So around 12 years back, I was giving home tuitions, and I have to travel from North Delhi to South Delhi for one tuition, and because they were giving me good amount of for per hour. And what happened one day, the student was having an exam, so he asked me to give me some more hours to clear my doubt. So I said, okay, I can give you. And with that time, I didn't check the time, and it happened that around 10 p.m. I realized, okay, it is now, it's very late. Those student offered me to, okay, my father will drop you to your place. But I didn't feel good. I feel okay, I'm earning, and so there must be a professional relationship with my student. So I said, okay, I can go. It's not a difficult task. Okay, I can manage. Then I took a bus, and I was in that bus, and there were 5 passengers. And suddenly I see a person with pen. I come into that bus, and he started selling his pen. And I was so surprised and amazed, even though there is a 5 or 6 passengers were there in the bus, but still the enthusiasm and the spirit, the person was selling his pen. I thought, okay, because I was having time. So I asked him, okay, why you are selling this pen? So then what happened? He gave his number to me. I asked his number, and then he gave his number to me. And he said, okay, because that time he was not having the time to share his story because we were in bus. So then I called him, and because I was very curious to know what is his story. So he said, me and my 2 sisters were left in a train by his uncle because his parents were died in very early ages. And so, to just feed his family, he was doing that. And he said, before doing that, I was selling papers, I was washing cars, and my sisters never feel good when I was doing that thing. So guys like you or person like you asked me, okay, why you are washing these clothes and washing this newspapers. So he said, I don't have any job, I am not educated, and I can do this kind of stuff. So then that person was working in a company, and he said, okay, I will give you some work. And that's how he got his work. And he said, and now I can earn with dignity, and day by day I am growing. And that person who give him a job, he said, the way you are doing your work before selling this pen, you have to work your work like that only. Don't be afraid. Don't feel ashamed of doing what you are doing. Whether it's somebody there, whether nobody is there, you have to justify your work. And after that, after listening to him, I feel very, emotional. And I said, God bless him. And we are still friends, and but we are not in touch. But yes, I found him in Facebook. So I sent him a friend request, and then it's a story. It's a true story. So the way we look our work, it's actually matters. It doesn't matter whether somebody is watching me or somebody is not watching me. And let me tell you one thing, when nobody is watching you and then how you are doing work, it's matter a lot. So don't be ashamed of doing anything if you feel it is important for your life. Take care. Goodbye.